Hi everyone, my name is Mohaiman, and in this tutorial, I'll show you with just one click how you can easily insert a table of contents into your Word document. I'll also show you how you can easily make changes to your contents, and in the end, you'll learn how you can add or remove subheadings in the contents. If you want to go specific chapter, I'll also include timestamps in the description. So without wasting time, let's jump to the PC. So I am on my PC and my professor gave me an assignment to write a paper on biocontrol of weeds in directed rice. So as you can see that I have already written a rough draft of 5 pages of my paper, and I have also inserted that contents in my documents. But let me tell you something, that's not the correct way you add contents in your document or your paper. With just one click, the Word will automatically add contents into your paper. As you can see that I have 6 headings in my paper and my 5th heading has 2 subheadings. So to insert table of contents, I'll go to my introduction, which is first heading, and from the styles I'll choose heading number 1 style. And for the next heading, I'll again select heading number 1, and for the 5th heading, I'll again select heading number 1. As I told you that my 5th heading has 2 subheadings, so for this I'll go to more, and then I'll select heading number 2, and then I'll again select heading number 2 for my subheading, and in the end I have conclusion. So for the conclusion, I'll select heading number 1. Now I'm going to start of my document. From tabs, I'll select references, and in the references I have an option which is table of contents, and I have built-in contents for me, which is table 1, table 2 and manual table. So but I'll click heading table number 1. So as you can see that the Word automatically inserted contents for me, and it also had the page number in front of each heading. My introduction is starting from page number 1, but I want the introduction to start from page number 2. So for this, I'll click here, and then I'll choose layout, breaks, and then I'll select page break. Now my introduction is at page number 2, but my table of contents is still showing the introduction as page number 1. So I'll just click here, and then I'll choose update table, and then there is an option which is update page number only, and then I click OK. So you can see that my entire contents is now updated. So one thing more that I want to tell you, that if I want to change my heading, or I just want to include something in my heading, say for example I'll choose introduction to rice. My contents is only showing introduction, so then I'll again click on update table, and then update entire table, and then I'll click OK. So my contents is updated to introduction to rice from introduction. And last but not the least, you don't want these subheadings in your document. So to remove this, just go to references and then click table of contents. And then we have an option which is custom table of contents. Just select this, and at this general we have an options which is show levels. So I only want to my heading to show level 1, and then I'll select 2, 1, and you can see that my heading level is only 1, and then I'll press OK. Replace this table of contents. Yes, so you can see that now the 5th heading have no subheadings. Now I want to remove the contents which I typed manually. So with this automatic table of contents, I can jump to a heading I want. Say for example I want to go to conclusion, I'll just hover my mouse to conclusion and just press control and then click to follow the link. So now I'm at my conclusion because the Word itself created a link to the conclusion. Okay, that brings us to the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. please like the video. If you have any question, leave a comment and subscribe to my channel if you want more tutorials like this.